So today is Empire Conference Day 3. The first session I went to was a century of transgender research. What has been learned with Dr. Doctor? This one was kind of controversial, of course, because going through the history of transgender research, it's come a long way, but you know, a lot of the theories that were out there even recently were no longer very good theories, so, or research, maybe not really good research. So it was interesting to talk about, you know, where the research was. And I think the main points I wanted to make was the people who say being trans is related to sexual desire. Basically, that correlation is not causation. That just because basically your sense of sexual identity in terms of what sex you are, male or female, really gets solidified in your teens, and that's also the same time that your libido is at its highest point for males especially, and for male-bodied people. So the fact that you are, you know, exploring things sexually because your libido is high, and also exploring things based on your gender, because that's when the differences between the genders start to, between men and women, start to become more obvious. I was just arguing that, you know, that may be just coincidence that those things are sometimes happen at the same time, and that when libido drops over time, that people's transgender identities do not dissipate because of that, even with the lack of sexual arousal. So that was just one thing I had to point out, because I know there's a lot of, especially older research, that kind of points in that direction. Also that it also used to have cross-dressing and transsexuality on one continuum, and the main separator was cross-dressing was seen as periodic, and transsexuality was seen as permanent. What I was pointing out is that they're really two separate. They're not totally unrelated, but they're kind of two separate issues. For cross-dressing, they appreciate the feminine gender expression more, but for transsexuals, it's more the physical body. A dysphoria or wishing they had a feminine body more. So, you know, it's, yeah, they're not completely separated, but they don't have to be completely separate. But I think it's kind of, it's not really right to think it's all on one continuum and one is just more temporary and one is more permanent. So, I mean, it's interesting to look at the history of research, and I think we've learned so much that looking back at that type of research, you do realize how controversial it is now and how maybe even the theories we have now might be controversial in the future, although I think we're pretty close with the latest theories on how things are. More because, you know, the trans people are able to tell their stories and it's not just researchers talking. We get to participate in the conversation more and people are not being excluded. So that was definitely made me think and want to express my point of view a lot, but I definitely don't agree with a lot of the old research out there in terms of even how it was constructed. So after that, I went to Donna Rose, the Mind, Body, Spirit Trinity. Alignment and your sense of self. So this one was like perfect for me. I mean, this is basically, I mean, it's all about balance. It's all about dealing with all aspects of life, not just the physical. She was describing her transition in her life and how things have opened up since transition. It hasn't, you know, really narrowed things for her. There's more questions, more possibilities. So, I mean, I just had to share my own story after I heard that about how, you know, my spiritual quest to sort of find myself was kind of key to me transitioning, and how it helped me, you know, really forget about what everyone else thinks and just really find out who I am, even apart from what I thought I was. So that was really, I mean, even though I always have to put my two cents in, I thought her just talking about her life and her ideas was really great. So I know she doesn't speak much anymore, but I was glad to do that. And it really should have been an easy choice for me, but anyway, at lunch, we listened to Silverman of the Transgender Legal Defense Fund. And it's, the title is We Will Be Free: Legal Developments on the Path to Transgender Equal Rights. And he talked about the different legal cases there are right now. And the main message was, you know, that we can be free and equal, but we have to work at it. If we just sit back and do nothing, then the people who are opposed to us are going to, they're going to keep fighting, and they're going to keep passing laws to discriminate against us or to remove our rights. So we have to, you know, keep supporting or making visible these cases. And, you know, I believe it also may be generational, that, you know, as we continue realizing that trans is part of the norm, it's not some kind of disorder or something other, that trans people are, you know, just another type of person, not just like cissexual and transsexual. They're basically, or cisgender and transgender, they're basically, you know, there are two options. And even though trans is rare, that doesn't, just because something is rare doesn't make it a disorder, that you can still be, you know, normal and productive. So, you know, I think we will gain the rights that we deserve, but, you know, we will be equal one day, but it may take time. It may be that there's, you know, we have to work at it to preserve what we have and to keep going, but that it takes a while. It takes time, and it may take older generations who have believe that sexuality or sex is something that can't change, that you can't change your sex, it's impossible, you know. That whole concept will eventually fade away with people who didn't believe that it was possible in the past. If they don't change their minds, of course. After that, I went to, again with the same gentleman, I went to Transgender Rights Update. So we talked more about the legal cases we had previously mentioned and just got more into the details of why these are issues and, you know, why they're important. So I had gone to this last year as well, but it was really good just to discuss, you know, the reasons why we have these gender specific jobs or locations like the bathroom, you know, and also where, you know, I mentioned how in other cultures it might not be the case, or even other areas of our country, it's not a problem for the, you know, whatever gender you are to perform a job or to go into any bathroom you want. So it's kind of a cultural thing more than it is a legal thing, but, you know, again, there's a danger that people will try to pass some laws that are more restrictive to trans people. So we have to keep fighting to remove the laws that are already out there that are discriminatory, but we have to make sure that they don't pass new laws which are even more restrictive, like removing our ability to even, you know, to pass laws. Like they basically want to pass a law that says not only can't you have a law against discrimination based on gender identity, but a local community is not allowed to pass that law. So it's basically taking away our right to even participate in democracy, which is, I mean, people who want limited government, that's basically, you're overstepping your bounds when you remove people's right to even try to pass a law. And that's what they're trying to do now. And the last thing we went to was, again, Donna Rose, the T in legacy, a personal perspective. So I talked about how, you know, people have paved the way for us and how we have to pave the way for future generations. So, I mean, we're living in a great time, but, you know, we can always make things better. There's still a lot of, you know, horrible stuff that gets done and discrimination and violence, so. And we can't, you know, basically discriminate against each other by saying that there's some kind of hierarchy of who's more real or whatever. That's what people who are opposed to us are doing, that everyone is unique and our humanity should come first. So this one was a little bit less of her personal story and a little bit more of why we should be active and participate and give back and all those type of things. And so I really enjoyed that as well. And after was a reception with the Transgender Legal Defense. So I got to sort of hang out and talk to a few people and just, you know, have my last chance to sort of see people before I was done. Whereas the, there was banquets and stuff after, but I didn't pay for those things, so. I definitely want to check out Donna Rose's book. I think it's called Wrapped in Blue. And I also talked to a photographer there several times, and she took my picture and stuff. She has a trans picture book. Her name is Mariette, I believe. So I'm going to look that up and probably get both those books. And, you know, I saw the book in my counselor's waiting room, so I was already kind of familiar with it. I'd thumbed through it a bit, but it's got stories and pictures of different trans people, so. Overall, it was a lot to take in, 3 days. Usually I don't do conventions that long, or, you know, I might do 2 days, but I think it was worthwhile, and I think in the future I'm going to be more social, I'm going to get more involved. I might even run a workshop of my own. I don't know if I'm going to do the social stuff yet. That's still kind of always up in the air for me. For one thing, it costs more money, and, you know, it's not exactly, it might be more fun, but it's not as educational, and I'm all about learning right now. So, yeah, I'll definitely be back next year, and it's in my hometown, so, or hometown area. So, it was definitely a good experience. Her name was Mariette Pathy Allen, and her book was The Gender Frontier. So I need to get that too. Definitely love to spend more time with my friends there too, or make new friends. My friends are sort of around, but I didn't get to see too much of them, so I think it's more fun to go with friends or try to make new friends, but that's kind of hard to do. So hopefully I'll see ya at one of these cons or these conferences, and I'll have more updates soon about what's gonna happen. So lots more videos are coming, just be patient. I'm sure I'll have lots to say in the future, but for now I'm just gonna keep doing things as I've been doing. All right, bye-bye. Peace.